So we are here with the one and only Ibrahim Khan, ambaye ni munshid anasifika sana Afrika Mashariki. Yeah, unajua anapenda kupika lakini hapendi kukata vitunguu. Nashid zake pia zimesifika mpaka United Kingdom. Kwa nini nikuambie mengi? Wacha tumsikize safari yake na hadi sasa alipofikia.
Ibrahim Khan is a young Quran reciter and a Nasheed artist. I would say it's a unique thing that I'm doing. We have Quran reciters in Africa and East Africa and all that, but I'm the only one who is doing it professionally, putting it out on my social medias and my YouTube pages and stuff like that. So yeah, basically I'm a Quran reciter and a Nasheed artist, and at the same time a student.
Okay, so this is it's a talent, so I can say, is it something that tunaweza sema kwamba ni it's a family thing?
Not really. I was the first half of our family, from our siblings. Then okay, now my brothers and sisters, all of them hafad, alhamdulillah. But in our whole family and the community that we were in, because I have a mixture of Baluch also, I was the only kid who did hifz and started doing Quran, the recitations and being an imam since I'm a kid. So basically I would say it's not a family thing. I did start it on my own, and alhamdulillah I've grown with it, and here I've reached alhamdulillah.
And is your family musical?
No, nothing. So am I not
musical. So say talent to
people have dreams, yeah. People have dreams, and if Allah Subhanahu wa Taala gives you the voice for it, it depends how you will use it. So, for example, like if you have a good voice, it's either you will become a singer or you will use it in the right way, where it can actually benefit you and benefit the people in the right way, in a positive way. So, I guess I really wish to be one of those Nasheed artists, because we used to listen Nasheeds and Quran at the time. So it was a very strict family that we had. My dad was very strict, no music at home and stuff like that. So I used to say, one day, inshallah, when I grow up, I want to become a Nasheed artist and a Quran reciter.
You are a student, so where do you school?
I actually finished my higher secondary in Islamic studies also. I did my secondary of school and higher secondary of Islamic studies also in Mombasa. Now I've come here, I'm looking for ways of starting my further studies, either going to university, but I'm not fully focused like which course that I want to go with. But I guess soon I will have a decision made in my mind that I will go for this. And part of the options that I have in my mind is journalism also. So I guess I'll come in your industry and take it over somehow. Maybe be a news anchor. But I don't want to go around look for news. I just want to be in the studio. If you had a teleprompter, I would have tried it. I would have tried doing news. But it's something that it's part of the options that I have. You know, in life you have to have plan A, plan B. So if the plan A doesn't work through and it doesn't go through, for example, like maybe you wanted to become a doctor and then it didn't go through, maybe due to several reasons. Maybe, for example, for funds, or maybe time, is you don't have that enough time for that. Or you know, other issues can come up which you have to change from the plan A, go to the plan B. So you have to have a plan B and C also. So my plan B was journalism, and it is something like I might do, I don't know, I'm not sure. But it's still plan B, it's not my plan A.
How do you start your day?
Basically, at the moment is I have to start up Fajr. If I don't get Fajr, maybe I slept late, I woke up a little bit late. My day is like, I really feel down, that's one thing. Alhamdulillah. So I have to start with Fajr, and if I have nothing to do in the daytime, for example, the morning time, so not the day time, but the morning times, if I have nothing to do, for example, if I don't have meetings or if I don't have any recordings that I'm doing, I could stay at home, maybe learn through tutorials from YouTube, maybe through on how to record or how to do different stuff. I try to write new lyrics as much as I can. It is hard, but you have to give it time, because it's a talent. And if you have a talent, you need to protect it, and that's how you protect it, by trying your best to make new stuff every now and then. Then I would say have my breakfast and everything. But if I have nothing to do, I'll stay at home. I don't like going outside much. But I have something to do, I normally don't don't waste my time on it. I'll go straight for it, and I'm on time on whatever I'll be doing, if I have an interview also or anything. Basically, that's how my day goes on. Salah after Salah, I have to, what do you call, go back to whatever I'm doing. If I was doing in the morning time, maybe I didn't, I don't have any meetings or, but I really wish once I settle down here in Nairobi, because I left Mombasa, I want to start my studies and not be more focused, because I know I'm waking up in the morning and I'm going straight to my class and stuff like that. So I do miss class.
Most of the celebrities want to go out and maybe, you know, oh, Ibrahim Khan, you know, taking selfies. You know, it should be like something you love, going out, spending most of your time, maybe just hanging out.
Depends on what you're doing, yeah. Because you might be known. Being known, it doesn't mean everybody who is known has the same perspective in life. You might have a perspective in life, you might have a vision in life, what you want to do. And it actually has to match with whatever you're doing. For example, if the way you say it, most of the time musicians do that, and we can do that. For me, if somebody asks for a picture, I do accept. I don't have a problem with it. That's the normal thing. It's because they love for me, so I cannot act that I'm too holy thing. So that's not how you get to the youth, first of all. We're in a different century. This is a different world we're living in. If you are too much of like strict, people will be away from you. Trust me.
Okay, as an artist and a Quran reciter, are there any musicians or maybe munshids and Quran reciters that you admire?
Yeah, several Quran reciters. I'm kind of choosy on Quran reciting. Quran reciters. I have like two that I really like, and we have Saad al-Ghamidi, and I have Idris Abkar and Raad al-Kurdi. These are three of my Quran reciters. I really like to listen to them. Munshids are Nasheed artists from outside, because that's how I got my inspiration from. Like, for example, I have Abu Ali, Raid al-Kahtani, Muhammad al-Muqit, Umar Isa. I have several of them. So it's something that I'm thinking, and I'm willing to. I have a vision of working with them, but it's just not the right time yet. Maybe because of investors and stuff like that. But if I get a person, let's say, it's a record label which will sign me in, and they can invest in my art or anything, I can work with them outside. I can work with the outside artist. I mean the international artist, and it's something that will bring up a bigger fan base. And I don't do it for show, so I know what my vision is, and that is somehow my secret at some point. But at the same time, we all need to make a living, right? So making a living, sometimes you need to get different fan bases. So that's how it is.
And do you perform in public?
Yeah, I've performed several. I've performed for even several great people from the government. Like I have performed for the First Lady in Intercontinental once. I've performed alongside. I've opened an event in Mombasa where Sheikh Nurdin Keshki was there. Tanzania also, I've performed in Tanzania. And several
of Kenya.
Bomos of Kenya, yeah. Also, when Mufti Meng came, the Honorable Najib Balala also called me for that event. We had a talk that I wanted to be part of the event. Then, alhamdulillah, he called me the last minute and I got it. And I opened his event when he came the last time. I think he's coming soon also, but I'm not part of this event. But the last one, alhamdulillah. So, yeah. But I still think it's somehow limited. I'm thinking, I wish to get bigger and more events. Understand? Like, not only in Kenya, but outside Kenya. Because Quran is something global. Every Muslim does listen and has to read. If you don't read and stuff like that, you're spoiling it. You're not following the deen yourself properly. And yes, we have this laziness where you can open Quran after 30 days. But we have to do up and down that. We at least recite, even if it's 2-3 pages a day, if you're that busy, let's say. But yeah, I pray and wish to get more of these events where I can perform and get more support from the public and the Muslim community. Understand? That's the problem which we have with as Muslims is that we don't have too much of supporting our own, and most of the times when it comes to Islamic contents and stuff like that, people who do Islamic content, there are very few who support these things. So, yeah.
So you know, I'll have questions like, is he single? You know, ladies.
Mm.
We've just been I'll receive such messages. So are you single?
Yes.
Married?
No, I'm not married now at the moment. I was. But I'm not married now. I'm kind of enjoying my peace of mind, I would say. I'm in a relationship with my own peace of mind. And yeah, alhamdulillah, I'm on my own at the moment.
So how many, maybe do you have albums of your nasheeds?
I have around 2 or 3, but I haven't released all of them. I've released several nasheeds, like 7, 6. They're on my YouTube page, but I'm thinking of releasing the other ones in a video form, understand? Not just the audio thing. And if it's the audio, people want the quality audio of the nasheeds, I want them to go and buy them through maybe iTunes or other applications where I will be sharing them through my social media. When you just search Ibrahim Khan Kenya, let's say on Instagram and Facebook, or those are my social media details, what do you call, account, sorry. So through that, people can follow up with my with my content and everything. They will know where to get them. But I would say I've released only one album.
And how often do you practice?
What?
Quran. Quran, it's a daily thing.
Yeah.
But sometimes
you become lazy.
And music, like
no,
the nasheed.
I don't
part.
Do music. I don't do
nasheed. And nasheed part.
So nasheed to me is like also everything, a daily thing, but it is it's something like I don't know how should I explain, but it's something like it goes with the mood. So if the mood is there of writing something new, and the tone comes, I can write it properly. If the mood is not there, I can't do it. I'm somehow I do things when the proper way, when I'm happy. Like I love cooking, but I can only cook when I am in a happy mood. When I'm in a happy mood, and when I have everything ready, because I don't like chopping off onions, those things.
So what kind of a cook are you?
Just onions. I don't like chopping off onions, and many people know that. Who know me well, they know I don't like chopping onions, but I like cooking. And but I am a happy cook. So for example, even in nasheeds, it's the same thing. When I'm in the mood and I'm kind of thinking of something, maybe a certain topic, it comes in my mind, then I have to start writing it. But I like when I start writing, at least I finish or reach 3/4 of it. I don't like leaving it in the middle.
What is your favorite nasheed so far that you've released?
I have nasheeds that I haven't released. Okay, the ones I've released, the favorite one is Mama, obviously. Everybody likes the Mama.
And what's your favorite part, maybe?
The whole thing, yeah. It has a very good message. And it is the message that, like, really reached the audience that I wanted. And alhamdulillah, many people, I've got good reviews back. For example, I've got a message, people saying, well, that because of your nasheed, me and my mom, we get along now. That's happiness to me. Like, okay, I've achieved one goal. You understand? That was one of the goals that I want. At least it can make a big difference to the community that will be listening to it, okay, be it a Muslim or a non-Muslim. That is the one that I've released. That's my favorite one, the one I've released. And the other one that I've released is The Morning Shines. I haven't released it as an official video, but we're planning to make an official video of it. But we've released an audio of it. It was released by the Merciful Servant page, the one which is in UK. They liked it. They, I gave them, and they made a lyrics video, and they released it, alhamdulillah. But I'm planning to make an official video of it. Just needs a proper timing and funds for that, because I don't want to make a video where somebody will just watch the video and is like, okay, it's not bad. I don't want that. I want somebody who wants to watch the video again and again. So if you want to make something good, obviously you have to go deep down in your pockets. And you have to go really deep in your pocket. For example, like for a video shoot, you have to have like maybe 100 to 120,000 shillings just for a song, for example, for a nasheed. Yeah. And even more, if you want to go to the next level, you can maybe spend 200,000 for that. If you want to have more things in your video, for more stuff in your video, for example, like you want to have a chopper in your video, for example, so you want to have a nice car on your, but I'm not onto that. I would like to have a chopper by the way in the video. That's a very good idea. So those things, any, the more you go, like the more professional you want to go, the more expensive it becomes. But for me, inshallah, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens his doors, and I can get sponsors, whoever will be watching this, come forward and sponsor the shoots of my Quran and the shoots, I would be very happy. I would be really appreciated.
And do you have any like the problems facing you in the journey
of your work? Yeah, yes, we have a lot. We have a lot. We're kind of limited. Some people think that these things are only should only be aired in Ramadan, which is a very useless thought. Some people think that this thing should be maybe played on Fridays, for example, which is a very useless thought also. For me, I want to break the limit, that limit that I've kept for us. For example, I want, even if it's my nasheed, they have an official video, be played in any program. Even if it's like, for example, a program which they're doing music, put mine in there. As long as my message is going out, I don't have a problem. As long as it's not Quran mixed up with music. But if it's nasheed, keep it there, it's okay. As long as the song goes out, a dirty song. Something like, for example, maybe you have a time, maybe they have normal songs going on. Put the nasheed there, no problem. As long as my message will reach to people, they might leave the music and listen to nasheed, you never know.
Any message for the youth who aspire to be like you, or maybe they are in the same journey as you, like Quran reciters, or they want to be great munshids in future?
It depends what you want. I always tell people, you have to have a vision. You have to work hard for whatever you're doing. Never let anybody belittle whatever you're doing. That's it. And you have to have the talent. That's the last thing. Not the last thing, by the way, that's the first or the second thing, I would say. And the vision comes up that, why am I doing this? Why am I being a Quran reciter and a nasheed artist? Why? That's the question. Once you know why you're doing all that, you will reach far. For example, Nia should be like, I'm doing it, okay, not because I want to become famous. Then you have a goal. I'm doing it because I want this message to reach to people. That is a goal. I'm doing it because I want to also make a living out of it. That's another goal. But if you don't have these goals, you're just doing it because Ibrahim Khan is known because of his work. Let me just try also doing it. You don't have the talent, for example. You just tried it. You went to the studio. You did it. It's not coming out well, but you're trying to push yourself to do it. Why? Because in your mind it's just, I want to become famous. No, that is a very wrong concept. Look where you're good at. You're good at, okay? For example, you might not be good. You might not be good in recording, for example, but you're good in drawing. Go into calligraphy. You can write ayats in nice ways of whatever you can do. You can be good in photography. Go into landscape, for example. You can make a living out of it. Understand? You're good in maybe designing clothes. Make nice clothes, people will buy. Respectful clothes, what I mean. Huh? I'm not meaning that clothes. So, basically, I would advise the youth, keep themselves away from this so-called maskanis thing. And you understand, wasting of your time with people who are not helpful in your life. And even the prophet say that if you live with a person who's selling fish, you'll sell. That's just a mithal. Eh? I'm not saying those people are selling fish are bad, but it was just like an example. He say that if you stay close to people who are doing bad things, you'll be doing the bad things also. So my advice for them, have a vision in your life. Work hard, have faith in Allah, and the journey is hard. Let me not lie to you. This thing is this. Whatever I'm doing is a very tough, you know, art and a tough industry, in which you'll have to sometimes even you can sit down and start stressing yourself because I'm taking this thing serious, so it does stress me at some point. Like, how will I do this to reach that goal of mine? So, getting the investors is an issue. If we have investors, even if it's a Muslim or a Muslim company. They want to come forward, I'll be very happy to work with them. See, all these things cost. But people are mostly just investing in musicians who are doing secular music. What about Muslims who, let's say, Islamic companies and stuff like that? Why don't you support us? We're doing Islamic content, you understand? So this is really bringing us back. But we believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I pray that he opens up his khair on this matter, and we will go forward, inshallah.
So maybe can you like recite something for us? Just
okay. I didn't see that one coming, but let me try. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فلما رأوه زلفة سيئت وجوه الذين كفروا وقيل هذا الذي كنتم به تدعون قل أرأيتم إن أهلكني الله ومن معي أو رحمنا فمن يجير الكافرين من عذاب أليم قل هو الرحمن آمنا به وعليه توكلنا فستعلمون من هو في ضلال مبين قل أرأيتم إن أصبح ماؤكم غورا فمن